Hello, this is Victor. I'm here with a new video, and this time I want to talk about a thing that I'm preparing for the next tournament. So yeah, I try to do these videos to help people that want to go first time to tournaments and see if these tips can help you. So I did some about preparing your own cards, and now I want to share this other thing that I'm preparing for the next tournament. So one thing I realized is I forgot a lot of rules when I'm playing games, when I'm playing, especially in the tournaments where you are in a rush or you want to go fast. So I'm forgetting a lot of rules, and then when the tournament is finished and when I'm reviewing the pictures and doing the battle report, I realized that I forgot some rules, I forgot to use some abilities, and yeah, and so on. I don't know if this will change my result, but I want to test something for the next tournament. So you can see here I prepare one page, and I think the trip here is to put one page with the main things I want to remember in each turn, or I want to remember during the tournament. And to be fair, the first thing is writing down the this will help a lot to remember. The point of writing down, it will help to remember when I'm going to play. But what I did here is I put the different phases, and then I put the things that I should do, or I should ask myself if I want to do or not. Let's put an example. So let's start with the hero phase. So in the hero phase, the first thing I put is common points. So I have to remember to put to add one common point. Storm Scroll, turn one. So this means that I have the Storm Scroll, it can cause mortal wounds, and it's more efficient in turn one, maybe two, depending what the enemy have on the battlefield. But it's important for me so to remember about that. Lantern Holy within 18 inches. So this means that I have to use the Castellan. Don't forget praise. Don't forget magic powers. And here I put the magic. I put also the endless spell so that I don't want to forget. And then I put the evocators, and they have the Azarit Halo. So these are some of the powers that I want to use. Then common abilities. I have to ask myself if I want to use the soul energy on the evocators. This is on the Lord Arcanum. Okay, so this is the things I need to remember in the, for example, the soul energy. I never use it. I never in any tournament, and it's quite interesting. So it's important to remember these things, right? Then we go to the movement. So the movement, yeah, we have the move. This is quite stupid. I should remove that. I have to remember that I have a staunch defender, and it's holy within 9 inches. So this is important when I'm doing the movement, that I don't go away from the staunch defender that is on my Lord Relictor. Units in reserve, end of the turn, so I have to remember to put the units in reserve, and then to keep the Judicators holy within 3 inches of the Liberator, because I have the formation that gives them to reroll once. And this is why I put this on remember. Remember, reroll once. This is going to be quite tricky, because these are things that are defensive, and are things that I don't know how to put in a way that is easy to remember, but I have to remember that I have to reroll once on Judicator saves. I have to remember that I have to reroll once on Evocator save against shooting. I always forgot this. Not the first one, because it's the first time I will use this formation, so this will put this. And I have to remember that the enemy have minus one to hit the turn I'm coming from reserve. So these are things that I never remember, and I want to see if this will help to me. At least writing down can help me. Shooting. I put the units that have shooting, and I'm putting that. I know ballista, adjudicators, and prosecutors with javelins I will not forget, most likely, but I forgot every time the Lord Celestine on the back of it. Every time. I don't know why, but it's something that I forgot a lot of times. Okay, charge. I put there that I have the common ability to reroll, so just for me to, it's only the thing. I know that my prosecutors have 3d6 to charge, something that I normally don't forget. So it is, I put things that I normally forget. Combat. Yeah, this is also defensive, but I have to remember that my Lord Arcanum can give one wound back on a unit, on a miniature that is being killed. I never use that ability. Never. And it's quite a good ability, and I always forget to use it. And I think I use Lord Arcanum since I have it. I use him in all my games except one. So I never use it because I always forget. Minus one to hit on the Lord Celestan. I forgot a lot of times that I have the armor that gives minus one to hit. So I put it there to see if I Don't forgot this time. There was one tournament that I remember every turn, and the tournament after I forgot it every turn, every battle. So this is something that I need to put on my brain. And then on the battle shock, I just put that I have the two common abilities. More likely, I will not need them, but it's important to remember that I have the two common abilities, and they can help a lot on the battle shock. So this is something that I was thinking. So things that you want to put on one page, on one page, to remember things that you normally forget in the tournament. When you, especially when you are in the rise, it's very easy to forget rules. It's very easy to forget abilities. So write down the abilities that you have. And sometimes we want to rise too much and we forget other things. In one of the tournaments, in one of my games, I forgot the hero phase. And another game, I forgot the movement phase because I was so excited shooting that I went directly to shooting. Okay, so it's something that I want to see if this helped me to be. This is a way for me to create a plan. This is a way for me to have a type of list of things that I have to do, and a way for me to try not to forget anything. Okay, for example, a typical thing that a lot of people forget is the scouts playing Warhammer 40k, especially if you put them on a hidden position. I have seen people in the turn 4, oh, I have the scouts here, I forgot about them. Okay, so this is quite common. Maybe if you make a list like this one, it's going to be much easier for you to remember all your abilities and don't to forget to shoot with one of the units on the battlefield because you just put them in a hidden position. I also have seen people forgetting to put, to bring from the reserve some units because they put it in deep strike or something like that and they forget to bring it on the battlefield. So here we have these points to remember. Just a tip that I want to share with you. Let me know what do you think. Let me know what is your opinion about using this type of list. I think can be helpful. But yeah, I'm looking forward to know what is your opinion. And yeah, what are your thoughts about this thing. That's all for now. I hope you have enjoyed this one. I hope this was something interesting for you. Give a like if you have liked it. Share if you think other people can benefit from that. And as usual, thanks a lot for watching and see you again later. Bye.